Let's do something on network analysis, and that is crashing. As far as network analysis is concerned about controlling the entire project, we have this technique known as crashing, which is actually a tool for analyzing the cheapest way of reducing the overall project duration. Remember, in any particular project undertaking, it is in order to actually reduce the project duration, even though there will be some element of incremental cost which will be incurred. And when we talk about this incremental cost of reducing the project duration, we actually talk about something to do with the cost slope. And a cost slope measures how much the cost is increasing with a unit time that is reduced for that particular project. And here we have an extract from a CASNAIP passport that was May 2014, question 5B. But before we actually examine this particular question, I want us to recall some two basic rules in crashing out of the many rules. And these two rules state that only the critical activities are crashed. Then the second rule states that you start by crashing activities with the least cost slope. And it means that we are supposed to go ahead and determine the cost slope. So I've just copy-pasted the question from the paper, of which we have the activities, their predecessors, normal time, crash time, then which will give us the time reduction or time reduced. Then we have the normal cost and crash cost, which will give us the cost increase. And then finally, we shall have the cost slope. Remember, we first start this particular work by drafting or drawing the network diagram, which you can actually do by looking at the activities versus their predecessors and the normal time, which gives us the duration, which will be taken by each and every activity. So for us to determine the time reduced, we actually subtract the crash time from the normal time, like 6 minus 2 is 4. This is 0. We have 4, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And then for us to get the cost increase or the incremental cost, we look at the formula. How do we get the incremental cost? We talk about the crash cost minus normal cost. Like for this particular activity A, it is the crash cost 100 minus 50, which is 50. 40 minus 40 is 0. 120 minus 40 is 80. This is 10. This is 5. This is 40. And this is 50. Then finally we have 120. Then, for us to get the cost slope, we actually subtract the cost increase, which is B. We divide the cost increase by the time reduced. You can recall the cost, the formula for the cost slope is cost increase over time reduction. So it is B over A. So 50 divided by 4 should give us 12.5. This one gives us 0. 80 divided by 4, we get a value of 20. 10 divided by 2 is 5. 5 divided by 1 is 5. 40 divided by 2, we get a value of 20. 50 divided by 1 is 50. Then 120 divided by 2, we get a value of 60. We can now go ahead and now draw the network diagram by following some two basic rules. For us to draw the network diagram, we normally check the activities versus their predecessors. And one of the rules for drawing the diagram that if an activity does not have a predecessor, in this case activity A and B doesn't have any predecessors, it means that they will normally start from the zero starting node. So we are going to have the first starting node, highlighted as 0. So we have the earliest starting node is 0. Of course, the latest starting node will also be 0, but in this case, we shall work forward as we determine the duration. Now, what are predecessors? These predecessor activities, they must first be completed before the actual activity is started. For example, activity C cannot begin until activity A is completed, likewise to activity D, which depends on A. So we have activity A and B beginning from the zero node, so we shall have activity A duration of 6 weeks. Then you have activity, that is activity A, taking a duration of 6 weeks. So it will end at 0 plus 6. Then you have activity B, taking a duration of 3 weeks. At what time will it activity B end? At 0 plus 3, which is 3. Then for us to draw the next activities, that is C, which begins as soon as activity A ends, we first check if an activity has a predecessor, or if that same activity is a predecessor of another activity. For example, in this case, we have activity C, which is a predecessor, or which precedes activity G. And it means for G to begin, C must be completed, or E. So it means G, the beginning of G depends on the latest activity between C and E, which one was completed at the latest duration. So it means we have activity C and D. D also originates from A. And likewise, we say that activity D also affects activity H. And either D or G, whichever will be completed latest, is when activity H is going to be initiated or to be started. So we can draw activity C as soon as activity A completes. You can have activity C, and activity C takes a duration of 10 weeks. That is, then activity GD also begins as soon as activity A ends. So we shall have activity D, that particular sector. So we have activity D taking a duration of 4 weeks. Sorry. Then we have activity E, which takes 2 weeks. And activity E depends on completion of B. And again, we check activity E. If activity E is a predecessor of another activity, for example, in this case, C and E affect G. So it means we have C and E begins as soon as C is completed. So it means these two activities, C and E, which takes a duration of 2 weeks. It means the beginning of this activity, the ending of this activity here, which affects G, should be the latest or the longest duration taken by either C or E, which is either 6 plus 10, that is 16, or 3 plus 2, which is 5. So we go with C, 16. That is the longest duration. Then, of course, after that, we have F, which begins as soon as B completes. And because F does not affect any other activity, and we don't actually know the ending terminal of this particular activity F, So we can just draw it and leave it that way. We shall determine its ending. So activity F takes a duration of 3 weeks. That particular case, we don't know where it will end. Then we proceed to activity G, which begins as soon as C and E ends. And C and E is this particular node here, that is the ending node of C and E. But again, as I said, is G a predecessor of another activity? Yes. It means that this activity G affects activity H in conjunction with activity D. So it means activity G connects again with activity D. So we have G taking a duration of 5 weeks. And again, whatever we are going to have, the ending node of activity D or G will be the longest duration, which is either 16 plus 5, which is 21, 6 plus 4, which is 10. So we go with the longest of 21. And then after that, we have activity H, which depends on D and G. Activity H depends on D and G. So we shall have activity H in this case, take a duration of 7 weeks. This activity H, of course, the longest duration is 21 plus 7, which is 28. And as a matter of fact, we should know that one of the basic rules is that there should be no danglers. Danglers means activities which does not have an ending, like this F. So it means we are going to join this particular activity to the final in this case. Now, what we have been doing is actually what is known as the forward pass. Now we want us to do the backward pass by working backwards. So the ending time here should always be similar to the latest finishing time. And for this particular activity, we subtract the duration. When you are going backwards, the backward pass involves subtracting the duration from the latest finishing time, like 28 minus 7, which should be 21. And then, of course, 28 minus 3 should give us 25 in that case. Then you have 21. Minus this is 5, we should get a value of 16. 21 minus. The next, now we talk about path analysis. Now, under path analysis, we shall actually look at all the possible routes that could be undertaken in this particular project. Like we have A, C, G, H. Another possible path could be A, C, I mean A, D, H. Another one could be B now. Start from B. We go to E, I mean B, E, G, H. Lastly, we could have B, F to the terminal node. Then we determine the duration for these particular paths, like the duration. How long does each duration take here? For example, we have the critical path taking a duration of 18, 28 days. This one takes 28 weeks, sorry. ADH, we have 6 plus 4, which is 10, plus 7, which is 17.
B3 plus 2, which is 5, plus this one, which is 10, again plus this one, which is 17, then BF, which is 3 plus 3, which gives us 6. So, after doing that one, we said that one of the basic rules is that we only crash the critical activities. Crashing means we crash them. You crash A. The first one should be A by how many weeks? The time that activity A was reduced. The time reduction of A was 4 weeks. So we crash by 4 weeks. And crashing means we reduce this duration by 4 and we get 24. Whatever we have A crashing by 4 weeks, like we have A here, we reduce this one by 4 weeks, we get a value of 13. We don't have A, so we retain the value. We have not crashed the duration. Do we have A? No, we retain the 6. After that, we crash the next activity along the critical path. Next one is this one here. So we crash activity C by the duration in which it was reduced. Time reduction was 4 weeks, again by 4 weeks. So we shall have, do we have C here? Yes. So we shall reduce this latest time by 20. Do we have C? No. So we retain that 13. Do we have C? No. We retain 17. These are C. Now we retain 6. Then we crash the next critical activity, which is G. So we crash G by the time G was reduced was 1 week. So by 1 week, do we have G here? Yes. So we reduce them by 1 week, which comes to 19. And then next, we're supposed to crash G in this case. We don't have G, so we shall retain the 13. Do we have G again? Here? Yes. By 1 week, it comes to 16. Then, do we have G? No. So we retain 6. And then lastly, we crash the last critical activity, which is actually crashing H by how many weeks? It was reduced by 2 weeks in this case, so he crashed by 2 weeks. Crashing this by 2 weeks gives us 17. But if we have H in this case, we crashed this one by 2 weeks, we have a value of 11. Do we have H here by 2 weeks? We have a value of 14. And then do we have any next value here by 2 weeks? 42 weeks, we get 6 because there's no H in that case. Then finally, we talk about analysis of additional cost. So we have analysis of additional cost, in which you're actually going to talk about each activity that was crashed, each critical activity. For example, we have activity, which was under the critical A, C, G, H, A, C, G, H, amount crashed, amount that it was crashed, which is actually the time reduction, and we have the time reduction for A was 4, C was 4, G was 1, H was 2. So we have A is 4 weeks, C is 4 weeks, G is 1, and then H is 2 weeks. We are supposed to multiply by the cost slope for each. The cost slope for A is 12.5. We have 12.5. C is 20. G is 50. And then H is 60. When you multiply those ones, you're supposed to get, if it's 50, you get 50, you get 40, 50, then you get 120. Total of these ones should give us the total additional cost, which is actually 130 plus 170, which is 300. And because they work in 1,000, should be 300,000. This is the cost that will be incurred to crash this particular project in order to actually reduce the duration overall. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.